There's something you don't see every day. A stupid bird. All dicked over, crashing into the window and into the light.
Alrighty, well, it's freaking Tuesday early morning, and I'm just rendering the vlog now, just giving her. And today we're going to try and use the Sony Bloggy. I forgot about this camera. I forgot I even own this camera. Go figure. So we'll give it a try. The only real issue with this camera is, I'm not sure what the issue is, but sometimes it acts up, sometimes it doesn't. But I never really used it much, so we'll give her a go and see how it is. Frig it. I already said that. I probably did. Oh well. Anyhoozle, I'm going outside for a cigarette. So yeah, I never really did give this camera a good enough try. You know, basically fired it up one day and went, yeah, it's not bad. Could be better. A little bit wider angle view would be nicer. Even though I do have a wide angle lens for it that I could easily slap on it and be done with it. And it would give me the wide angle I'm looking for. I love the fact that it has the screen on the front of it so I can see myself while I'm filming. So that's pretty good for a pocket camera. I wish I could hold it upright like a flip though, but you know, can't have that. But that's fine, that's fine. All in all, it's a pretty good camera, I guess. Frig it. We'll use this for today and see what you guys say. And hey, we're made of clay. It also has a video light, which is nice. So that's a bonus. So yeah, I'm just rendering the vlog right now and having a cigarette. I gotta wake up the girlfriend in a couple minutes, get her started on her epic quest, and I'm probably gonna spend the rest of my night playing some Grand Theft Auto 4, because I haven't played that in a long time, and I kinda sorta maybe miss it. So, frig it. Do some missions for GTA 4. Why not? Hammer down. I really wish there was an easier way to hold this thing. Because you gotta hold it sideways type, it's kind of awkward, so I'm gonna be fiddling with it, trying to figure out the proper way to hold it. That's what she said, I guess, eh? Frig. But, yeah, I don't think there's much else going on tonight, so probably just gonna cut her short from tonight, and we'll carry on tomorrow afternoon when I get out of bed, and I'll let you know how the night went. You know, if the girlfriend actually let me catch any sleep or not. Guess we'll find out, frig's sakes, and other things. So talk to you guys in the PM. Peace out. Alrighty, well, it's 3:30 in the morning, and once again, I have to re-render the vlog. While I'm rendering the vlog, I am also in a chat room with friggin' T-Man's Go-Karts. Can't remember this guy's channel name, but, let's find out who they are. Well, let's find out who the other guy is here. There we go. Hey, other guy in this chat, what's your YouTube channel? They have no idea I'm vlogging right now either. They have no idea. Right now I got my headphones on because I'm listening to them talk, but, they're getting the channel name. He's trying to figure it out and stuff. I guess he doesn't watch his own videos. I don't know. But, yeah. So there's the other guy's channel, David IRA Mills. David IRA Mills. And, yeah. So there you go. Friggin' David IRA Mills and T-Man's Go-Karts. In a live chat with them while waiting for the vlog to render. Right on. Anyway, guys. I'm gonna carry on with this and re-render the vlog and get that son of a bitch stoked up to YouTube, so let's friggin' do it. Alrighty, well, I'm not sure how well you can see me right now, but it's currently 5:30 in the morning, and I've switched to the Canon ELPH300 because I was getting sick and tired of the Sony Bloggy screwing me over. So, I still got some more work to do before I go to bed, so that's all I'm gonna do now, and just gonna friggin' give her. So, once again, talk to you guys in the PM.
Alrighty, well, it's like Tuesday afternoon. Yeah, it's Tuesday afternoon. I'm a little discombobulated and stuff. Look at that. Freaking super blue skies. Gotta love it. Gotta freaking love it. So yeah, sure enough, it's like, what time is it? Yeah, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I didn't get to bed last night till like 6:30 a.m. Because I was up really late and chatting on that T-Man's Go-Kart chats, and then sure enough, I go to sleep and found out that my Samsung TV in the bedroom is dead. Yeah, girlfriend turned it off, and now she will not turn back on. Ah, well, I might just go out and buy 2 monitors, put them on my editing computer, and then go ahead and move the LG TV from the red room to the bedroom so we have a TV to watch stuff on when we go to sleep. And then maybe I'll just destroy that Samsung somehow, drag it behind a car or something. I don't know. We'll figure it out. This guy is being a whiny little bitch, whining away. I don't know what the hell his problem is. Kind of pisses me off, but whatever. Also, the other option is 32-inch TVs always come on sale at around Christmas time. So, you know, Boxing Day, just go and pick up a new 32-inch TV and be done with it. Frig it. Yup. Feels weird to be filming with this thing again, but frig it. It's a lot easier than using the Flip. It's a wider angle too than my freaking Panasonic, that's for sure. Holy shit. I was reviewing some footage last night there, and wow. This thing does pretty damn good, I have to admit. So, yeah, it's like 2, probably 10 after 2 by now. And I gotta get ready for work in about an hour. I don't feel up to doing anything special today. So, frag it, you know. up so late last night, hanging out in that chat room, and then, you know, talking go-kart talk and stuff, trying to find parts. And I showed T-Man the, can't remember who sent me the link, but somebody sent me a link to a Canadian distributor who sells stuff for go-karts and things. And it was basically a hub for the 1-inch axle, 1/4-inch keyway that allowed you to hook tires onto it, 4-bolt tires. Problem is, the tires that you can use have a, it was 2 13/16 by 4. So we looked at the tire sizes that you can use on that, and the tires are tiny. They're really small, so you couldn't use a big tire on it. So once again, ground clearance will be an issue. So if, let's say I get my go-kart done and Rex has his mower and we go up to the pits or something, well, I'm going to be riding on the skid plate a lot, and I kind of don't want to do that. So that kind of sucks. Still, the best tires I can get are the ones from the States, from BMI Karts, but the shipping is going to be dicked. And once they hit the border, that's going to hurt too. So frig sakes. Oh well, I'll have to figure it out. But yeah, it's the way she goes. Friggin' shipping, I tell ya.
Oh, freak sakes, if you're wondering why the video looked kind of awkward a while ago and why I was getting wind noise, it's because I never installed the battery on it yet. I never installed the Band-Aid on it yet. So now we got the Band-Aid mod installed on the Canon ELPH300HS. And I'm holding it with my back to a fan, and hopefully there is no wind noise. So, yeah, it was that fan there, holding it in front of it and stuff. Hopefully that alleviates all the wind noise. So, yeah, it's about 2:45 now. I've just been modding the camera, getting it ready for tonight because we're going to need it. Love using this thing. It's a freaking awesome camera. I've said that many times. And apparently I was wrong on the wide-angledness. Apparently the lower the MM, the better the angle, and this camera proves it because it only has a 21.5mm wide-angle lens. So, yeah, it really proves it because, like, look at this. This is awesome. Freaking right as it is. Well, I'm going to have to go make a lunch and stuff and get ready. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So, let's go do it. Alrighty, so once again, I made modifications to the wind filter on the Canon here. Put it in front of the fan. Hopefully this works, because I have no idea what I did last time to make it work so well, because last time it was epic, and this time around not so much, so Alrighty, well, got my lunch packed up, and I'm ready to rock. So it's off to work time for me, you know, just another exciting day at the office and things. Doing this one-handed sucks, but yeah, I don't think I can film in the car. Because, like I said, this camera has that 10-minute turn-off time and things. So, frig it. So we'll have to do some chit-chatting when I get to work or whatever. So, let's hammer down. Alrighty, frig it. We're gonna try and vlog and drive, and hopefully the camera doesn't cut out in 10 minutes. But right now, I'm having a bitch of a time getting around these girls because, there we go. I don't understand that, why teenagers do that, you know? Like, they all walk down the street, but rather than walking in a single file, they walk side by side and take up the entire road. Then they see a car coming at them. They refuse to move out of the way. So it's like, what are you doing? Do you want to die? Because last time I checked, my car ramming into you will probably kill your ass. Just saying, you know?
So I don't understand why teenagers nowadays have such a freaking death way. Oh, I gotta walk side by side with all my friends. We're in a freaking rock video, you know? Holy shit, people are stupid. And that's why, my friends, that's why I smoke. Helps alleviate the stress from the stupidity around me. Well, looks like Pisser's channel's back, eh, people? I know a bunch of you out there were the ones who pointed me in Pisser's direction when I had some body work questions and stuff. And I started watching his channel, and I guess the goofs got to him. Probably made a threat where they said, if you don't stop your channel, then we're gonna friggin' do something rude to you. I don't know what they did, but they pissed him off completely, and he went and yanked it. Just out of the blue. I guess he just rage quitted, and you know what? Sometimes there's days I want to do that too. But he ended up bringing it back. Bringing back the channel. His new channel is Pisser's Channel, but the L at the end is not an L, it's a capital I. I'll throw a link in the description if you want to check it out. So there'll be three links in the description for you to check out. T-Man's Carts, friggin' Pisser's new channel for all the people who miss him and can't find him. And there'll also be a link down there for the other buddy there, David, which I can't, David Ira Missile or something like that. I'm not sure what it is. But I'll put his channel down there too if you want to go check out some trike action. All custom builders, all DIY guys. You know, the only thing I'm DIY is with computers or electronics. Now, you know, I say that and then I talk about gonna smash that Samsung TV. And you're probably all thinking, well, Adam, if you're a DIY electronics guy, why don't you try and salvage the Samsung TV and actually put it back to work in the bedroom? Well, honestly, I'd like to get rid of one of the 32-inch TVs, so if I did salvage it and got it working back pro, I'd probably end up selling it on Kijiji for like $100 or something just to get rid of it, because I really, really, really want the dual monitor setup in the Red Room for video editing. It'd make my life so much freaking easier to have dual monitors for video editing. Like, let me tell you, it would be awesome. But then the girlfriend's talking about buying a Mac for the bedroom, one of the 27-inch jobbies, and using that as like the media PC where we can watch movies off of it, or she can use it. And she wants to buy herself a MacBook, so somewhere she plans on winning the lottery. I don't know how, but whatever. And she wants to buy a MacBook and an iMac and put them in the Red Room. Or in the Red Room, in the bedroom. She's gonna have her MacBook for playing World of Warcraft and stuff on downstairs and such. And then upstairs she'll have the iMac to use, and we can use it for watching movies at night and stuff and other things. And my XPS 9000, I'd probably move that over to the Red Room and use that as my gaming PC. Strictly use the 8300 for video rendering. It would no longer be a gaming rig, because the 9000, it's got the i7 920 2.66 gigahertz quad core with the ATI 5870, which is a pretty damn good card still. It's got the big 1 terabyte hard drive into it, and yeah, it's not a bad rig. So I'd probably use that for gaming and all my stupid stuff, and then use the 8300 for video editing strictly. So all in all, it'd be pretty good, pretty damn good. It's been a while since I've used this camera, this freaking Canon. I know I got 4 minutes of video that I'm allowed to take, so you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna restart the video feed. Frig it. So many people I know today are sick. My friend Molly has a wicked cold. A bunch of other people I know have wicked colds. I just keep popping the antihistamines to counteract my cold, but I have a wicked cold. But I have a pretty bad cold happening. I have a pretty good headache going on and stuff. Frig it. I gotta go to work. Gotta earn some moolah, you know? You know what I'm saying? Because every day I'm shuffling. You know? There's some berries over at that house. Pretty cocked. So tonight's a two-man crew, because we got one guy off Tuesday, Wednesdays, and another guy booked today, tomorrow, and Thursday off. So that sucks. But oh well. Whatevs. The year is almost over too. That's pretty dicked. We're about to roll into October. Like, time is flying by so freaking fast. You have to have a dream to just hold on. You know what I'm saying? That's from Jermaine Jackson, When the Rain Begins to Fall, just so you all know. 1980s music quotes for the win, let me tell you. That's where it's at. All the best music was brought up in the 80s. That shit they're playing on the radio now that they call music, it's nothing but freaking blips and bleeps. Hell, I can make it, for frank's sakes. What does that tell you?
Oh, but Adam, Nickelback's amazing.
Shut up. Nickelback's not amazing.
Never made it as a white man. Never touched a friggin' hot pan. I'm a loser with a voice. I talk like I have a frog in my throat. This is how you remind me why I'm freaking gay, you know?
Freaking Nickelback. Freaking hate Nickelback.
Goofs.
I wonder if Canada apologized for Nickelback yet. I know they apologized for Bryan Adams, like, profusely. Okay, well, I gotta give her. Because that transport's making a turn, and he's gonna just cock me over. Holy shit. I almost got killed, people. Yeah, not a fan of the Nickelback. You know what they say about Nickelback, eh? If they charged 5 cents to go see the concert, when the concert was over, you wanted your frickin' Nickelback. That's why they called themselves that. And then we always called them Theory of a Nickel Creed. Like Theory of a Dead Man, Nickelback, and Creed, they all sound the same.
They all have that raspy voice and talk like they have a frog in the throat.
Alrighty. We're at work now, so I'm gonna head her inside and just give her. So I'll talk to you guys on the flip side. So peace the frig out. Alrighty, well, first break of the evening, and it's 6 o'clock, so frig it. Oh, see that car, Primer Gray? Why? Because Ray's car. But seriously, yeah, it's been hell on earth since we got in today. We come in and find out the network's down. Also to find out that we are short on staff. So that's freaking fun. That's been a good night so far. But yeah, apparently the network was down because somebody neglected to check to see when the domain was going to expire and let it expire, and that just copped over the program. Everybody's email couldn't be checked. All the services that we offered were offline. Domain naming services, all sorts of shit that was down to the domain name that just completely shit the bed. So, right on. Way to go, team, you know. Oh, and I got an email from my boss because yesterday I took a call for a printer repair and I didn't document the name of the printer, you know. I don't know if you guys can hear that, but there's some noise coming from that couch. I don't know why people are dumping off the landfill here. They're not supposed to. Oh, well. So, yeah, it's been busier than shit. And on top of that, it's just two of us, me and Buddy. And it's friggin' brutal. It's like nonstop, call after call. It's going to be two-man crew until Friday. So that's going to suck, but oh, well. The way she goes. At least I got my cigarette breaks. Friggin' need my cigarette breaks. Oh, to think, if I had an iPhone 5 right now, I'd be using that instead of the Canon. Wouldn't that suck? You guys probably love that. Maybe, probably not. Who knows? But I would be. Just cause. I use my iPhone 4, but I'm not a fan of the whole 640 by 480 picture. I like widescreen. Widescreen's my favorite. So, yeah. So honestly, I didn't know that. The millimeter of the lens. The lower the number, the wider the angle that the lens will produce. I didn't know that. I thought you wanted a higher millimeter on your lens to get a wide angle. So that's friggin' awesome. Because yeah, this Canon ELPH 300HS has a nice wide angle onto it. And that's what first got me on this camera, was the fact that no wide angle lens needed, had great video. One thing I didn't look at was audio. All the friggin' tests I looked at online didn't have any audio. Music playing in the background and people filming things like waterfalls and, you know, shooting their family portraits and stuff like that. And I was like, holy shit, that camera is nice. And it does 1080p. Too bad it does 1080p at 24 frames a second. So I just hammer down the 720p at 30 and go from there. Frig it. Like, the only way I could actually use 1080p is if I set up my program, my Sony Vegas, to render, or set up the actual initial file as a 24p file and then uploaded or drop my videos in that way. That's the only way it would properly work, but you know what? I just don't feel like it. 30 frames, frig it, good enough for me. Yeah, I'm just rambling on. Look at me go, eh? Freaking just rambling. There's no wind today. Today would have been a good day for the flip, but I think this camera does a way better job. I don't know, you be the judge. I think it does a pretty good job. The audio's kind of kife, but whatevs. Just crank your speakers. That's the way she goes. Any hoozle. I should head her back inside and carry on my night. I don't think there's anything else to talk about. Frig it. That's what I'm going to do. Head her back inside. So I'll talk to you guys on my next break. Peace out. Alrighty, well, it's 8 o'clock lunchtime, and I freaking love how this camera works in the dark. It makes such a clean and crisp picture. There's also a motorbike parked over there in the guest parking. Let's go take a look at it. This should be fun. I don't think it's Rex's.
No, it can't be.
Also, haven't seen my gopher buddy in a while. Don't know where the frig he is. Frig it.
Oh yeah, that's definitely not Rex's bike. You want to know why it's not Rex's bike? Because it's not a bike.
It's that little scooter. Or is it an EcoPad? I think it might be an EcoPad. Yeah, it's a freaking EcoPad. Oh shit. Right on. It must be somewhere farting around, who knows. Little EcoPad. A Ruggo e-bikes.
Ruggo, whatever. Let's go with it.
Not sure why they parked it over here and then frigged off, unless they went to the gym and there's no parking over there for scooters and e-bikes. Who knows? But yeah, it's another one of those nights. Been busier than shit. You know, people calling him in about the freaking issues that we're having and stuff, and it's been bullshit, but we're just getting her done. Getting her freaking done. Oh well, I'm on a late lunch too. It's actually 8:15 because my co-worker got stuck on a call, which delayed his lunch. This is about 7:15. He ended up going at 7:30. So now I go 8:15 to 9. Not a big freaking deal. Oh, there's the motorbike owner. Right on. So I'm not sure what's going on after work. I'm pretty sure the girlfriend's still playing World of Warcraft. Just leveling. Oh shit, that thing moves at a good clip. Just freaking giving her. There's no freaking way in hell that thing's legal. Holy shit. That thing was just booking her. I've never seen them go that fast. That's impressive. Rugo. I bet you if I got on that thing, I'd be lucky if I got that thing doing 2 kilometers an hour. Oh, the train, people. The train. But, yeah, so far tonight's been going by fast because we've been busier than shit. So it'll be over soon, and then tomorrow is Wednesday, which is an awesome day because it's hump day, halfway through the weekday. And for me, it's day 4 of 6. And then I work Thursday, Friday, I have Saturday, Sunday off. I have to work Thanksgiving in October. Not a big deal. I opted for it because, well, let's face it, I want the money. So frig it, hammer down, right? But yeah, it's lunchtime. Cat Piss sent me some videos from his iPhone. He used the front-facing camera and the rear-facing camera just to show me the difference. And the rear-facing camera, surprisingly enough, does a superb, sharp job. It does a great job. 1080p, 30 frames per second, looks nice. Front-facing camera, 720p, I would compare it to a flip cam or a Kodak, like the Kodak Playful. It actually looks pretty damn much on par with that. Yeah, I think if I had the iPhone 5, I'd probably be vlogging with that instead of this. I'm just saying, it'd be easier to carry one device than two. But, whatever. Any hoozle. I'm gonna head her back inside. I'm pretty much done my cigarette and eat some lunch and then go from there. So, I'll talk to you guys on my next break, even though all I do is ramble. Rambling's fun, because I'm a rambling man. Oh, it's friggin' 10:30. Came out for my cigarette break. And that noise you're hearing on the camera, that would be rain. Because she's pissing out again. Son of a bitch. God, this weather's pissing me right off. You know, it was all sunny and stuff today, and now it's pissing. Like, friggin' make up your mind. Oh well. Well, I'm not gonna keep the camera running too long. It's finally starting to slow down, so right on. Just take her easy for the rest of the night, and I'll talk to you guys when I come out for my last, when I come out at midnight. You know what I mean. Anyway, shutting her down. Talk to you later. Alrighty, well, it's friggin' midnight. Time to get the hell out of here. Look, you can tell. I'm heading off to the Hortons to meet up with Rex 4x4, so let's hammer it out.
Alrighty, down here at the Hortons. Let's go inside and see what the frig's going on.
Alrighty, well, we're down here at the Hortons, and Adrian showed up for his break, and...
Holy shit.
Yep, that's Adrian, people. He's a special breed. But he's got to go back to work in his... Really? Really? I heard the hood crumple, bro. Oh, good thing it's a Chevy and it bounces back, eh?
Yeah, there's the old hood.
He's got to go back to work, and Rex and I are probably just going to play some more BS racing. We were playing with Adrian, but... Oh, horn blows. Apparently so does the driver. But we were playing some BS racing, but Adrian didn't have a hopped-up car, and he was getting his bum killed, and he was mad.
Like, I didn't enjoy it at all.
Nope. We were overlapping him. It was awesome.
I hate being overlapped.
Yeah, he does.
It's me crying in the pants. Yeah.
You ever see a guy throw an iPhone 4? Me neither. It didn't happen. Don't worry about it. But yeah, it was a good time.
Game close.
Alrighty, well, Adrian's got to bounce. You gonna do a burnout? I know. Company car, you can't.
That's as high as I can rev it.
Holy crap, that was like 8,000 RPM. Oh, you found it.
I missed it.
See you later, buddy.
Bye, buddy. No hands.
Well, it's 1:38 in the morning, people.
Rex's bike is out there. You can somewhat see it in the window, maybe probably not with a reflection. Yet another night. This guy's got to drive home.
Drenched. Again.
Drenched. Soaked. It's completely saturated. It was dry. You guys saw that. Remember at 10:30 I had to stop vlogging because of the rain. And I was worried about killing my camera because I need this. And then came here and it was nice out. There wasn't a cloud in the sky. I actually saw some stars. And then the shit clouds rolled in to ruin the parade. It's what they do. So, you know, it's no longer a motorbike. It's now a jet ski. Jet ski. Go with it.
Alrighty, well, people. We're going to call her a night at the Hortons. Rex is going to jump on his Suzuki. Such a sexy bike. I like it. He sent me some pictures today from Carlson Sports and Marine, I think it's called. Carlson Sports? Carlson Sports, yeah. And they had a Honda XL. What size was that? It didn't say on the paper. 600? 650. Okay, so it's a 650. And they wanted $4,500 for it. Freaking nice. But I can't right now because I need to save up for my trip. Ooh, she's gold. She's not a happy bike, she's cold.
So he's gonna let this warm up, I'm gonna have a cigarette, and then we're gonna friggin' hit the road and call her a night. Let's do this.
There's something you don't see every day. A stupid bird. All dicked over, crashing into the window and into the light. That thing is frigged right up. I don't even know where the hell it went. Huh. Oh well. Pretty cocked over. Something probably got him. I don't think it was Felix or Oreo. You never know though.
Well, there's something you don't see every day, eh? Freaking retarded bird crashing into my window and shit. His leg looked a little cocked over, so something probably beat the living crap out of him. And now he's just trying to find a warm place to sleep. So chances are I'm gonna try and get into my house and that little peckerhead's gonna come flying in. So I guess Felix will have some food. Because if it comes in the house, I'm gonna kill it. That's the key rule I have with critters. You come into the house, that means you came in there to die. So don't come into the house, you won't die. Simple as that. Come on, critters, pull up. Well, once again, I was, I think I mentioned it in the beginning of the vlog, I was chatting on T-Man's go-kart site last night, and we were talking about the go-kart build, which has taken forever because I haven't done anything to it. And basically what he told me was, I showed him that, I can, like, once again, I can't remember who sent it to me, but there was an axle and or a freaking hub. And the problem with the hub is the size of tires you get to use on it. And they're really, 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 really small. They're smaller than these ones that are on there right now. And you know what, if that's the case, I'm better off go back to the go-kart tires that subwoofer's sitting on. Might as well, like, but those are slicks and they'd be horrible in the dirt. Two options. One option is cut off the axle, like take off the bearings and all that shit, take the axle off, bring it to Princess Auto, and replace the 1-inch axle with a 3/4-inch axle, 1-inch key or 1/4-inch keyway, which means I can run a lot of different types of tires. I had a set in here that I could run, and I have no idea where the frig they went. I don't know what I did with them. Frig sakes, lost some tires. That's awesome. But I can run those other tires that have the 3/4-inch axle, 1/4-inch keyway, or I can run those little friggin' things, you know, whatever, and be done with it. Or buy the hubs from BMI Carts, pay at the ass for shipping and handling, and actually buy the tires from BMI Carts, pay at the ass for shipping and handling, stove them on that 1-inch axle and be done with it. So, yeah, I don't know, we're gonna have to wait and see what we're gonna do. Obviously this build's taking forever, and the reason why is because I'm having a bitch of a time finding parts, and finding parts sucks. But I might have a guy who knows a guy with a guy who runs a tire company who might be able to get me a deal on some tires. I don't know, we'll have to see. So I might be able to get something that'll fit that axle. But that's all I'm doing now, guys, just hunting for parts to get the job done. I don't know how long it's going to take, you know, whatever, it's the way she goes. But anyhoozle, I'm going to shut the vlog down here, people, because it's getting late. I need to edit and upload and all that jazz, and it's like 3:00 in the morning and stuff. So yeah, good times. So if you liked today's video, you know what to do. Go ahead and hit the like button. Let me know you like the video and I like that. If you like the fact that I use the Canon ELPH300HS, hit the like button again, because frig, why not? Stuffing junk. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, leave them in the comment section below, and I'll be sure to respond. And until next time, guys, keep on vlogging.
We're home now at the sub place. Had some submarines, freaking awesome. I'm nice and full. Nice and full up. And Oreo's running around. That's what you're hearing is this guy. Just like chitter chatter, chitter chatter, chitter chatter. And So yeah, we're back. Panasonic's gone. I was told from Future Shop that if they don't get it fixed in 60 days, on the 61st day, I get a new camera. So we'll have to see what they do. I honestly think it's just a ribbon cable that's either crimped, cut, or loose, or disabled, or whatever. It's making the connection sometimes, but a lot of times it doesn't. But I guess we'll have to wait and see what it is. So they'll take a look at that and fix it up. Other things. So right on. But camera's gone. So now I'm rocking out with the flip. That's probably what I'll be using for the time being. I might bust out the other Panasonic from time to time, but it's pretty big and heavy to carry around. Not the ideal camera for me to bring to work. Frig it. And I got my other Panasonic, the TA2K. So if I need to use that, I'll use that as well. But right on. So anyways, it's 3 o'clock. Gonna have to get ready for work soon. Frig sakes. And give her. So.